Welcome back, Matt.
Thank you.
So just as discussed previously, I do have some topics which were identified as the important problems that Texas is facing. And this was a political project which was conducted at the Texas University at Austin. So I would like to have your opinion. We can go one after other. So the first one, the border security. So what's your take on border security?
We need a secure southern border. Drug cartels and gangs are terrorizing so many communities on our southern border. We have a human trafficking problem that we need to address, and children are being caught in the wake of it. We've, in the last two budgets, appropriated about $700 million per budget towards border security. And when you go down there, DPS is a very visible force on our southern border. It's helped to reduce crime. It's helped to reduce illegal border crossings, which we do want to reduce because, obviously, we don't, as part of our immigration policy, we want to encourage legal immigration and not allow people to cut in line in front of those who have not abused the process.
And what's your opinion on the political corruption and leadership?
I think we need to do more to fight it. We've actually passed a bill last session, which I helped pass, that removes the pension for lawmakers and government officials that have been convicted of felonies. I think we need to go further. I think we need more transparency and more disclosures for contracts that government officials have with private companies. I think we need more transparency. I also think we need a limitation on government officials becoming lobbyists after they retire from the legislature. So often, legislators will take a job lobbying right after they leave the legislature. I think that needs to stop.
Next in the list, about the education.
Education, we need to continue to fund enrollment growth, and we need to direct more money to the classroom and pay higher salaries to attract better teachers.
And then healthcare?
In healthcare, I'm actually a healthcare attorney, so this is something that's important to me. The government micromanaging our healthcare system and getting involved has skewed our healthcare system so badly and increased costs. Have you seen since Obamacare was passed, healthcare costs have skyrocketed? We need to promote more competition in healthcare. We need more competition, and we need less government in healthcare so we can reduce costs on the consumer.
Gun control and gun violence.
Well, gun violence is very serious. One of the very interesting things is since Texas has reduced its gun control over the last 30 years, the murder rate's actually been cut in half. So we don't want to impose a law that's going to actually increase the murder rate or increase the crime rate. So we need to focus on what actually works. And Senator Ted Cruz and Chuck Grassley actually had a bill in the federal U.S. Congress that would put more money towards funding enforcement of gun crimes. I think we need more prosecution of gun crimes. I think we also need to make sure that our national background check system is accurate, and that we actually get the information we need to the FBI so that guns aren't put in the hands of people who are going to use them for bad purpose.
And how about the immigration one, which actually accounts to 16% of the, when they did the survey?
Yeah, immigration, my philosophy on immigration can be summed up in four words: illegal bad, legal good. And I think we need to encourage legal immigration and make it easier. It's simply incomprehensible that there's a 150-year wait for EB-2 visas out of India, a 17-year wait for EB-1 visas, and even among the highest category, a 6-year wait. We need to reduce those lines, remove the country caps, institute a merit-based system, and encourage more legal employment-based immigration.
And coming to the local control, so how will you work to ensure that the local governments are free to determine the best policies for the state?
That's always a tricky issue, because we want the governments who are closer to the people to be free to regulate where regulation is appropriate. However, if you remember, the most local level of control is the people themselves. So if it's an area where the government shouldn't be regulating, I think the state needs to make sure that the people are free in that area. like, for example, property taxes. We need lower property taxes, and I think the state should see to it that we have them.
So coming to the property taxes, so what plans are you going to adopt to reduce them or to make them stagnant?
I think we're going to use state money to buy down the property tax rate. So we still fund our schools the same amount of money, but more of that money is coming from the state rather than your property taxes. So your rates should actually go down if we institute my plan. Also, Governor Abbott's plan is a 2.5% cap on property taxes without a taxpayer vote. You should get the chance to veto any tax increase over 2.5%.
And coming to women's rights, what efforts are you going to do to make sure that one can do with one's body is not it's extended to all citizens and not only to men. It's not just kept to men.
Well, I mean, I think we need to protect liberty. I think when you address any issue, whether it be for men or women, you need to address the issue that a person should have the liberty to do what they want as long as they're not harming another person. The tricky issue comes where that language is often used with the abortion issue. And in that choice, there's another person that's actually involved as well. And that's the unborn child. So I've been a very big pro-life advocate in protecting the unborn as well as protecting the rights of women as well.
And coming to the infrastructure, according to the American Society of Civil Engineering, Texas has been identified at risk in 7 different categories, so which include dams, drinking water, flood control, highways, roads, and wastewater. So how are you dedicated to focus towards building or rebuilding our state to state is in its order?
Well, I mean, we need to prioritize infrastructure in our state budget. It's a tricky balance always when you're doing a state budget, because you don't want to increase taxes, which will result in less revenue as well as less money in people's pockets. So we want to make sure that economic growth continues, and keeping taxes low is a part of that. So within what we have in the budget, we need to prioritize education and infrastructure. Among infrastructures are the areas you mentioned, especially our roads and congestion. And I think we need to make sure that we build the roads we need without tolls that price so many people off our highways.
And the child services, and how are you planning to protect the Texas most vulnerable citizens?
Child Protective Services was in a sad state prior to this session. And I'm so happy that Governor Abbott took the leadership to reform our CPS system. And what we did was we tried to increase incentives for kinship care, for family members to care for foster children. We also provided more caseworkers and tried to lessen caseloads on caseworkers to protect our children. And we've actually been seeing results from that. I think we'll probably need to do more. However, we're seeing the results and are going to follow it up next session and continue to protect our most vulnerable children. I was very proud to be a co-author of that bill that reformed our CPS system as well.
And the last thing in my list is about the public transportation. Mm-hmm. So how are you planning to improve the public transportation system?
I guess the biggest public transportation issue has been the high-speed rail. And one of the great things about Texas, and what I always love about Texas, is private industry fills in wherever you let them thrive. And what we have now is a high-speed rail from Texas to Houston, and it's being funded completely by private money. In fact, there is a bill that no state money could be used for it. And it looks like it's going to succeed, and I truly hope it does. I think we need to incentivize projects like that that'll provide more options for commuters and other individuals.
So Matt, let's take a break over here, mm-hmm. and come back and discuss about some national hot news which are in the headlines.
Yeah, great. Sure. Thank you.